Hi there, my name is Parker Beal, and this is The Last Few Years, a web series about women's fashion from the past century and how gender roles, current events, and societal expectations play into the way that women present themselves to the world. The 1940s was a decade of sorrow, patriotism, and hope, and it was the beginning of a new era. Ever since the Great Depression, fashion was used in an escape. In this decade, fashion took on a new role. Women's fashion was very similar to men's fashion. It was men tailored dresses, coats, and hats. These fashions weren't idealizing life, but making it obvious that you were supporting the war effort by wearing these clothes. During this time, since most women were drafted in the war, a woman's duty was to take care of the home front, taking jobs previously held by men. The clothing was conservative and practical, with a military feel. It wasn't until the later parts of the century that women would adopt the Dior look. Basically, fashion in the 40s was to show how patriotic you were. Everything you did was for the war effort, to the jobs you worked, to the way that you fed your kids. The philosophy, of course, affected fashion. Much like in the 30s, the way women dressed was to lift spirits, to show that hard times can be made into something good. If you didn't give up enough or not dress a certain way, you could be seen as not patriotic or even shunned. Women were once again made to mask the true effects of war on a common person. The role we had was to uplift spirits and keep the men able to do their job serving their country. At the same time, the war probably couldn't have been fought without us. We were the ones building their machines. We kept the country while they were away. In my outfit, I'm wearing a cream-colored blouse that is actually authentic from the 40s. This is one of my favorite pieces for this series. It has a small v-neck and cute pearly buttons. The skirt I'm wearing goes down to right above my knee, which is about as far as skirts would go. It's a really pretty green color and is slightly pleated, and since I don't have stockings with a line on the back, I do what any 1940s woman would do, and I drew a line down the back of my leg with eyeliner. I'm also wearing a simple string of pearls and a vintage watch. I really liked this outfit. It's pretty and feminine while still being very easy to move around in. It's really interesting to see how much was given for the war effort, especially when it comes to women's clothing. Now onto the fun part of this look, my hair and makeup. My hair is put up into victory rolls, one of the most popular styles of the 1940s. It was both a good way to show that you were a patriotic citizen and a good way to keep your hair out of your face while you were working. My makeup is relatively simple, with an exception of the lipstick. Women were encouraged to wear makeup all the time to hide sadness and attract men. My eyebrows are drawn in their natural arch and shaping, but they are darker than they would be naturally. They weren't tweezed to be super thin, but they are neat and groomed. My eyes have very minimal amounts of makeup, with only Vaseline and a thick coating of mascara on my upper and lower lashes. My base powder is the same shade as my skin tone, but slightly bronze shades from your natural color were very popular too. My rouge is a pinky rose shade applied on the cheekbones sparingly. Finally, the most important part of the look, the lipstick. Lipstick was marketed to keep up women's spirits during the war and to show your support for the troops. Basically, fashion in the 1940s was to show how patriotic you were. Everything you did was for the war effort, to the jobs you worked, to the way that you fed your kids, and what you fed your kids. That philosophy, of course, had to affect fashion. Much like in the 30s, women's fashion was to lift spirits, to show that hard times can be made into something good. If you didn't give up enough or not dress a certain way, you could be seen as non-patriotic or even considered not an American. The role that women had were to mask the true effects of war on the common people. We were to lift spirits and keep the men able to do their duty fighting for their country. At the same time, the war probably couldn't have been won without us. We were the ones building their machines, and we kept the country going while they were away. Thank you so much for watching this episode of The Last Few Years. If you want to see more of me and more of historical fashion, click the like and subscribe buttons down below, and don't forget to turn on post notifications to know each time I post a new video. Next time, we'll be talking about fashions from the 1950s and how the post-war world evolved. Thank you so much, and I can't wait to see you next time.